bowel disease is a condition where a portion of the intestine has been removed and nutrient absorption is impaired. In this video, we will identify what leads to short bowel syndrome, explain bowel adaptation, and identify the consequences and symptoms of it. In many of the lower GI disorders, there is a significant intestinal damage that can become so severe that a portion of the organ must be removed and remaining organs reconnected. When the damaged area is removed and resected, the intestine will be shorter. It can also be due to congenital malformations or poorly functioning portions of the organs. As we learned previously, the intestines are necessary for absorption of all nutrients. Depending upon what part of the intestines are removed will determine the consequences we will see in short bowel. This graphic shows us an overview of what is absorbed in each section of the intestines and the possible consequences. Looking at the graphic, one would think the worst part to lose would be the first part of the small intestine because that is where most of the nutrients are absorbed. But in reality, the last portion of the small intestine is most critical. The reason for this is because the bowel has an amazing ability to adapt. The remaining tissue will thicken and adapt, taking on the responsibility of the section that was removed. However, if this adaptation does not occur, the consequence is malabsorption of most nutrients. This is what clinicians refer to as short bowel syndrome. It is the impaired intestinal function due to the absence of portions of the intestine. The symptoms are similar to other malabsorptive disorders, with diarrhea, bloating, fatigue, and weight loss as primary symptoms. Bowel adaptation is the key to preventing the devastating consequences of short bowel syndrome. Knowing this, you can begin thinking about how diet could help in the prevention and treatment.